there's no one way of finding a particular cast. Every project we have to, you know, use a kind of a different technique. A lot of time we also have to do a lot of back and forth with the director in terms of what kind of actors will work. Sometimes the audition is great. Sometimes we know the actor is very good and he might do very well, but the audition is kind of not that good because it's you're judging them on the basis of one day of how they perform.
Welcome, welcome, Yash, and thank you so much for joining. So glad
thank
to have you.
Thank you, Shaif.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing well, yeah. How are you?
I'm good, thank you, thank you. First of all, I wanted to actually congratulate you, you know, because you've got multiple projects this year. Like you got Chintu Ka Birthday and Shakuntala Devi. You got Kray Dads and obviously Mirzapur. So, obviously in an eventful year. I just wanted to check how has the pandemic affected the whole process and the whole work you have, because casting requires perhaps a physical interaction, right? So how has that affected your work?
So the good thing with me was that I've been working since the past 4 years. The experience that I gained during that time has really helped me now that I know actors, I know really well what kind of roles an actor can do and all. Because in this time, in these times when there's no physical auditions going on, all we can, and all the producers and the directors, they can work around is the judgment of the casting directors. And it has really helped me a lot because we've been doing self auditions. A lot of things have changed. For like 3 to 4 months, we were not working only. Then slowly and gradually, we started doing ad films. And then web shows also started. Now films have also started. I did Bhoot Police recently, which I started after things started in terms of the lockdown was lifted. So the entire film, the casting we did in about 1.5-2 months. And half of the film is already shot. It's being shot in Dharamshala and Himachal. Basically, then depends because you're doing self-tapes and a lot of times it's difficult for actors to record, you know, when there's no one to give cues and no one to give proper directions. So yes, as directors also, they trust us now so that we can tell them exactly what kind of actors can work for a part. And then on the basis of that self-tape, we are now working ahead on all our projects.
Well, that sounds a lot of work. I think, but
there's a lot of back and forth that goes on because an actor records an audition, they send us the tape, then we have feedback, then they record it again, and sometimes the lighting is poor, sometimes there are different things that needs to be, you know, rectified and all. So yeah, there's a lot of back and forth. So we also have, you know, kind of been very patient with the work, with the way the work is going on. But yes, we are more happy than the work has started. The films have, you know, started going on floors, and we just hope that they release in theaters soon as well.
So as you mentioned, your job as a casting director, you know, it starts very early in the production of a movie or a web show. So could you please describe the process of how casting works to our audience and also talk about your role as casting director?
So our job is straight, like we get the script. First of all, either the director or the producer, they hire us. We go through the script, we develop our own brief, we share it with the director, then they tell us what their brief is regarding the film, what kind of film they're trying to make, whether they want to go with real characters, raw faces, new faces, or they want kind of little established actors to pull that off. Everything depends upon the vision of the director. So we have a long, like a week long back and forth going on. Regarding what the brief of the whole casting of the film is. And accordingly, then we source out actors, we share the actors with them, they kind of tell us whether we are going on the right track, then accordingly we find more actors, we audition them, we tell them what to wear for the auditions, so that a director can also visualize them what they can do in a particular character. An actor can be really good in general, but we might find someone absolutely new and fresh who might do better, you know, in a particular character. So it's not always that you need an actor who is a pass out from NSD or FTII, which are like premium acting institutes. A lot of times, like even in our upcoming show, Bhag Bini Bhag. Dolly Singh is there. She plays Swara's best friend and she has a very interesting track. So for that, we, I think, auditioned about 100 girls. And after that, Dolly, who is the first time, like, this is her first web show. She's, you know, she's a big name. And I've, like, always been following her work on Instagram. But this is a very different platform when there's a camera in front of you. There are 100 people around you and you have to act. You have to be another character rather than just doing your own thing. So, yeah, there's no one way of finding a particular cast. Every project we have to, you know, use a kind of a different technique and source out actors. And then a lot of time we also have to do a lot of back and forth with the director in terms of what kind of actors will work. Sometimes the audition is great. Sometimes we know the actor is very good and he might do very well, but the audition is kind of not that good because it's you're judging them on the basis of one day of how they perform. So that is one thing that I, you know, then try to tell my directors that it's not just the performance during the audition that works. It's also what the actor can bring in from their own experiences and the things that they've done before. So that is where the casting directors come into play. And we also then put in our word and then it's the director's call. So yeah, then there are workshops. Then even if there's a new actor who is not that trained, like with Dolly also, we did a lot of workshops. There's a workshop facilitator, Pooja Swaroop, who trained her for 5 to 6 days, helped her become the character Kapi. And that's how, you know, then they finally go on floors and shoot the film.
Sounds like a fun process altogether.
Yeah.
So you're talking about Bhag Bini Bhag, and I think apart from that, you have another movie coming, Durgamati. And they are going to stream in two big platforms. So how excited are you for both the projects? And also I wanted to ask, which platform is your personal favorite perhaps?
My favorite platform as an audience nowadays is Sony Live, because the kind of content they're coming through with is kind of really remarkable. The kind of projects they have backed, that is Rajat Kapoor Kadak or maybe Scam 1992. They're like really path-breaking shows and films. And there's someone who is saying that you make a good film, you make a good show, and we'll back it, irrespective of the people or the stars that are attached to it. As far as my projects are concerned, I'm really excited for Bhag Bini Bhag as well as for Durgamati. We worked on both the projects in around the end of last year. And finally, we were lucky that they got shot just before the pandemic. During the pandemic, the production houses could, you know, work on the post-production because people could stay at their homes and edit the film or do the sound and things like that. So we were lucky in that way. So both the projects are coming out this month now.
Right. I'm excited for you, man. Actually, both of them look very good. And
they're very, very different projects also. That's something that I like to work on different scripts with different directors, new directors, like even on the show. We have three different directors. We have Debbie Rao, we have Abhi Varghese, we have Ishan Nayar. Each of them are very different from one another. And they, you know, got a lot of freshness into the show because we also would see the show from three different perspectives. At the same time, they're following the same narrative.
Right.
This is something new for us also to work with different directors on a single project. I think whatever happened was good for the show. Yeah.
So recently, we have been seeing a lot of cred ads, especially during the IPL times, you know, for it, and it's getting a lot of popularity for its innovation, creativity, and obviously nostalgia. So could you tell us how it all started, the idea of it and everything? And also, how was it for you to work with such great stars of our cinema industry?
So a lot of people do confuse that I actually did the casting for the ad. No. My friend Kashish Arora was the casting director on that. And because the thing was that it was shot during the, like, just when the lockdown was lifted. And there weren't many people in Mumbai who were, like, in terms of the actors, most of them were back in the city and things like that. So I just got a random call that there's the ad film that they're casting for and they would like to audition me for that. So I'm not an actor, but that's what I personally feel like. You need not be an actor to do all kind of roles. A lot of time casting also depends upon casting the right face for a character. So I think Kashish thought that I might fit the part. So he called me for an audition. I recorded a self-test. I sent it to them. The director liked it. And then I was called on set. We shot for 2 days. And just to shoot with people like Govinda, to shoot with people like Anil Kapoor, Madhuri Dixit, Bappi Lahiri, and a lot of other people. Like, it was like really like it was fun because we've just grown up watching all of them perform. Absolutely. In different capacities, and watching Anil Kapoor do the Lakhan steps, or watching Govinda do his, it was full of nostalgia, and it was like a really special project for me.
Definitely, definitely. It looked like you enjoyed acting, I guess.
Yeah, it is like, I'm not an actor, but yes, if there's something interesting and if the director feels that, I might work around. So yeah, why not?
Absolutely. We would actually love to see more of you in that zone.
Yeah.
So yes, usually pursuing a career as a casting director or in casting department is not very common. You know, it's not usually heard of. So what sparked you to take up this path, and how did your journey in the casting department begin?
So I was always fascinated by films since I was a kid. So that is the reason why I'm doing what I'm doing. So yeah, it was always that I wanted to be in films, but at one point of time there wasn't a casting department that used to function, especially when I was growing up. Casting actually took the center stage around mid-2000s, when and in fact around 2010-12, especially post Gangs of Wasseypur, when a lot of people were brought in from theater and things like that. So that was around the time when I was in 12th grade. And I was also figuring out what to do next. I was always inclined, and I was doing a lot of theater in Delhi. And at the same time, just watching people who like I know personally who are good theater actors getting all kind of good roles. May it be someone like Kumud Mishra sir in Rockstar, and even other people who are actors first rather than stars.
Right.
So that really motivated me, like, yes, the industry is changing for good. And yes, at that point of time, for the next 2-3 years, I was just doing theater, and then Dangal came. And when I saw Dangal and I saw the potential of casting, you know, especially for a film that is so huge with Aamir Khan as the lead, and at the same time, that these two girls that break out and shine, and are just, you know, the find of the year, like some that way. So that really motivated me to then properly, you know, start my journey as a casting director. So I started assisting on films. I started assisting, I assisted on Mirzapur, and I did a lot of ads as a casting assistant. And then after 5 to 6 months, I think Chintuka Birthday happened.
So that was that your first project, Chintuka Birthday?
Yes, that was my first project that I did independently.
And how difficult or easy was it?
So I started off as, you know, just finding out the Iraqi actor. Because the film was written in 2007 and was supposed to be in production a couple of times before it actually did. And I was fortunate enough to just be at the right time, the right place, meet Tanmay. And he shared the brief with me. I spoke to the directors. They had a little difficulty in finding the Iraqi actor. That is played eventually by Khalid Masu from Palestine. So yes, it was a very challenging process because I was already working as a casting assistant. So I used to work till 8 to 10 p.m. In my company, in the casting company. And then I used to come back, and the entire night I used to research on the Iraqi actors, because at that point of time, there used to be evening over there. So they used to respond to me around 1 or 2 a.m. in India. So that was a crazy 2 to 3 months of work, but I really enjoyed that process a lot because I did something that I've never done before, and I haven't done something like that even after Chintuka Birthday. So that was a special project.
Talking about casting, you know, how did that casting happen, and why do you think it was important for you to start casting at that given point of time?
It was very important for me because I was just fascinated by, you know, the freshness that started coming in post, and I started working professionally around the time when web series were at boom. There was TVF who had just entered. There were a lot of other people who had started working on web shows and things like that. And now, since the last 2-3 years, I think we are onto another level only in terms of the web content that we're doing.
Absolutely.
So I think the you know, kind of the leeway that we got in terms of casting was something that I even hadn't seen in films, because with films, there's a particular setup, there's a first act, second act, third act, and the kind of characters also that we get to cast is kind of you know what the characters and the actors are. But in terms of web, there's complete freshness. You can do and you can cast from anywhere. You can cast. There's no restriction of box office and other stuff. So that is something that really struck a chord with me. I actually was planning to go into direction to assist on films. Wow. Casting just happened by luck that I happened to be at Casting Bay, and I worked there for 6 months just to explore what, you know, the scene is in like casting. And that really shaped me up, like my time over there, it really shaped me up. It taught me a lot of things. And at the same time, I started, developing my independent voice in terms of as a casting director. So that really helped me a lot whenever I used to meet any director and talk to them regarding characters and actors and things like that. I, rather than just, working, I used to learn a lot. So that is something I still do whenever I work on any project. There's so much to learn and do. And casting is something that, is kind of, it changes with every film. It's not like a job like a DOP or an editor that the patterns are kind of same. Right. You can play around with a lot of stuff. So that really gives me a lot of, motivation to cast better and to find out, think out of the box. And that is something that is if you're working as a casting director, to, bring some kind of freshness into the films. And so that is something that I look forward to doing for the next, I don't know how many years. And I think people have started taking casting more seriously these days. That is just because of the hard work that is required during the process. It's equally as hard as any other process. So I think we still have a long way to go in terms of getting more and more fresh people into the industry and into limelight. And we're happy that people like Pratik Gandhi and Shreya Dhanmantri and a lot of other people who, found their due and who've been given their due and respect and other stuff also since the boom in the OTT industry. And we just look forward to working more.
Absolutely. We are glad that actually casting started and you guys are giving opportunities to many people. And it's good to see the growth of, casting and you as well. So that's commendable. So, Yash, as you were talking about working for various web shows and movies, so you are someone who has worked for both the platforms, I would say, like OTT platform as well as cinema industry, let's say. So what is the difference you find in both, like work-wise and your perspective? And what are your views about both the platforms we have?
I've been actually lucky enough to work in different industries, maybe advertising. I do a lot of ad films as well. I do a lot of web shows as well as films. So that also keeps me fresh in terms of, because in advertising, the time is less. You need to focus on, cracking the thing correct in a lesser duration of time. In films and web, you still get a lot of time to, explore different people, audition them, things like that. So obviously advertising also helps while you're casting for films and all. In terms of films versus OTT, I think the process is the same because you get 3 to 4 months of casting at least, and the audition process is the same. The kind of work that happens at the back end is kind of the same. Just that with OTT, you get an added advantage of introducing more and more people because the kind of and the amount of characters that are being written, because it's not just a 3 hours of content, it's like 5 to 6 hours at least. So there are a lot of characters, there are a lot of story arcs, and even in terms of getting a good actor, we feel good because there's a lot to perform as well for them. I love working on web shows just because of the fact that there's so much to explore in terms of getting good actors on board and finding different roles, different characters. With films, it's kind of a little restricted because in that 2.5-3 hours, you can just tell one story, and there are only that many characters in the film. So that is something that is like a difference for me. Apart from that, everything is kind of the same.
For a movie like Shakuntala Devi, which is a biopic, what are the measures you take, or is there a different process for such a movie?
There is, because the film is based on real life characters, and we have a reference image of Shakuntala Devi. I found out who the daughter was, who the son-in-law was, and how did Shakuntala look when she was young? How did Vidyanam look when she was young?
Right.
So I got pictures of all of them, and then we tried to keep it as real as possible. Find actors that are really true to the character. Suppose Shakuntala's husband was Bengali, so we tried and found Jishu sir on board, who is a very big star in Bengal. At the same time, he's a really good actor. And the biggest compliment was that Shakuntala Devi's daughter was really happy with the casting of her father. And that's how, you know whether it's working or not in terms of biopics. When the people who are actually associated with the film are happy, that means that your job is done.
Absolutely, absolutely. That's good to hear.
Yeah.
Yes, when we talk about casting, one big name that comes to my mind is of Mukesh Chhabra. You know, he has been in the industry for a very long time, and I think he has had a big role, I would say. So what do you think the kind of impact he had on the industry, or probably on you, or the whole department, the whole scene of casting?
As I told you, like, Dangal was a very big reason why I am into casting. That motivated me a lot. So kudos to him and his team for finding out those gems. Apart from that as well, he started off and he got casting into limelight. So that's always something that you need to credit him for. Apart from that, there are a lot of different good casting directors who are working these days, who are really doing the job really well. And you also need to acknowledge a lot of other people as well. This casting bay, there are a lot of other, there's Nandini, Shrikant, there are a lot of other casting directors who, and it's a very demanding job, because until the film goes on floors, everyone is just waiting for the actors. The costume department can only work when they know what the measurements of an actor is. And same with other departments as well. So everything kind of boils down to who the actors are. And it's a really tough job. And people like Mukesh and Casting Bay and Nandini, they've been guiding, us also. We also feel motivated with the kind of work that they do. And we also then are very close. It's a small family of casting directors. We are closely associated with each another, and that is something that I really like about the industry. Like, even if we are kind of not competing, but yes, there that many films only that are happening. At the same time, there's a very nice atmosphere around, with newer people coming in, setting up their own companies, and finding their own voices. And that's a good thing that is with them, that they also motivate and support and help us out whenever we're stuck. So that's,
absolutely, absolutely. I think the whole scene is growing together, if I have to put it
correct
in that way. Right. So yes, what is the most challenging project you have taken so far, and why was it difficult or challenging for you?
For me, all the ad films are challenging, because every art film comes with 2 to 3 days of prep, and during that period you need to find the actors. A lot of times you need to cast somewhere around 15 to 20 actors for an art film within span of 4 to 5 days. So that's a task in itself. So I love whenever I get a casting of any art film that's hard to cast, whether finding out different kind of people, musicians, other stuff. So that really challenges me a lot, and I really like challenges. So yeah, advertising is something that I really enjoy in terms of,
Absolutely. So yes, this is one question I wanted to ask you personally. So we don't see too many casting agencies down in South. Why do you think that disparity?
The thing is that they've started. I don't remember. I just did a interview with Film Companion also, where they were talking about the rise of casting directors down south. The thing is that the way the casting industry has developed in Hindi films is commendable in the last 10 years, over the last 10 years. And I think slowly and gradually, people down south also will kind of take casting as a profession seriously. A lot of times, even now, the assistant directors over there are only casting for films. But slowly and gradually, there are some names coming up who are now professionally taking up casting as a profession in films down south. And I really hope that in the next 2 to 3 years, we also have a professional industry over there.
So going ahead, yes, what all films and shows can we wait, which you are associated with?
As of the announced, as of now, I think Bhootpolis is something that is announced. Right. So I hope it comes out sometime next year. Then I'm working on 3 to 4 web shows. I don't know if I'm allowed to talk about them right now.
Maybe off the camera.
But yeah, maybe off the camera with different platforms, with Sony Live, right, with Netflix, with Amazon. So yeah, there are a lot of interesting stuff in the pipeline. There are a couple of anthologies that are going on. So that is again a different and a new thing for me to work with different directors on a single project, on different films. I really enjoy working with different people. And you know, you get to learn a lot of new stuff, work with a lot of different minds, a lot of different perspectives. So that really keeps me going, because if you're just working with one production house or one director, then you kind of know what they require, you know what works for them. But yeah, putting yourself out there with different people, that is something really challenging for me.
Absolutely. Looks like a busy year ahead for you, and I'm very happy to hear that. So yes, do you want to recommend 5 movies or shows, you know, which you feel that everyone should watch out?
I'll just recommend the shows that I watched during the lockdown and I really liked. I really liked Scam. I really liked Patal Lok. And then there's a lot of shows like this Crown. I really like Crown.
It's
amazing. I'm a big Game of Thrones fan. So a lot of, like 90% of the people have already watched Game of Thrones. If the 10% who haven't yet watched, please do watch Game of Thrones. and you can watch all of casting's film, that is Shakuntala Devi.
Absolutely.
And Durgavati next.
Definitely. Yeah. I did one of my favorite shows which you were involved is Hostel Days. I really like that show. I think season 2
is a fun show. Yes, I think they're currently shooting for Hostel Days season 2. I'm not attached to that project, but yeah, I worked on the first season and that was a lot of fun. It's always fun collaborating with TVF because they have a lot of new energy. Like Raghav Subbu, it was his first show as far as I remember. He directed Kota Factory after that, but it came out first.
It had
a very young vibe to it. Like when we were casting for it and we were given an open hand in finding out new actors, exploring different stuff. So the guy who plays Jar Shwamgor, so he wasn't an actor. He used to do there was one show of his on YouTube channel that used to come out. So we kind of found him from there. And after that, he's doing well now in terms of having his own voice on digital platforms.
Absolutely. So yes, when you talk about casting all these people, so I'm assuming that you wouldn't like go after you get a brief from the director or writer. You know, maybe you would have few people in mind, or you keep scouting people around, or like, how does that work? Like, do you always keep scouting? You have some people in bank, or you just go after you get a brief?
So my thing is that we interact with a lot of people, and I like interacting with people. So my office is on like every day. We've shut it down just because of the pandemic. But prior to that, every day we used to have open introductions in our office. So if an actor is new and they haven't met us or met my team, they could just, you know, come down to our office, meet us, tell us about themselves. So that way we were always open to, you know, discovering and finding out new people. And when we kind of have something for them, we usually call them and audition them. And if you're a good actor, and even if you don't get a part, you know, a good audition always stays with the casting director. Right. So it's very much important to be associated with, you know, to keep trying and keep auditioning and you know, just doing your best. Because a lot of times, a lot of things happen that you don't get a part. But if your audition is good and if you're a good actor, you'll always remember, I'll always remember you. So when I'm meeting any director and I know of, you know, if you are fit for any character, so I always discuss actors with, you know, even in my first meetings, and I'm very instinctive. So when I'm reading the script or when a director is telling me something about the project, and if I have some people in mind in terms of people who've auditioned with me before or who are good actors, I've seen their work, I've seen them in a play. I usually go to a lot of plays in Prithvi Theatre, even other theatre group with other theatre groups. Our team is always on the lookout for actors from different cities, from different theatre groups. So yeah, and not only from theatre groups, on different platforms as well, because especially with digital, the digital revolution, you don't need to, you know, just be associated with theater. If even if you are a very interesting personality and you have your own thing, we can spot you from there also. So that is how things have evolved. And yes, for me, while reading the scripts, I start getting people in mind, and that just forms my first opinion. But yeah, a lot of things happen after that also. Like when we start the audition process, it's a long process and it's a very collaborative stuff. A lot of times the director has someone in mind. A lot of times even costume designers suggest us, have you met this guy? He's really good and he might work in for the part. And we audition them and we find that they're really good. So for us, it's always like the brief is always open. We have no restrictions as such that we'll only audition these 10, 15, 20, 30, 40 people. It's just about finding the right actor for a particular character. And yeah, so we're always open in finding. A lot of times it happens that I was just working on a Netflix show. So for that, we started casting around February and we locked the primary cast in September. So we auditioned approximately 150 to 200 actors at least, even more, I think so. And that's how we found the lead character. So yeah, a lot of times it's just very instinctive that you already know who this guy is. And the first person you audition is the one who gets a part, just because you know that he is that character. But a lot of time you find it through, you know, just exploring different stuff and just, you know, trying as much as you can. So there's no one way. So, yeah.
Absolutely. So before we wrap up, Yash, I just have one last question. So we have seen you acting in Kredak, and then also I remember you were in Muska as well. So what can we see you once again donning the hat of acting, and what do you think of your acting career going ahead?
For me, I'm not a professional actor. I like even with Craig, there was Tanmay Bhatt, who was a creative director. I used to work at AIB before, so I kind of knew him really well. I worked with him in Chintu. So yeah, obviously it's even with Maska, the producer Seher Latif is a very I've worked with her a lot in terms of on Shakuntala Devi. She was my co-casting director and she was also the executive producer on that project. On Maska, she was the producer and she just asked me to do a cameo, so I said yes. So my kind of acting is very much into just cameos and all. So yeah, if there is any good cameo role just for 1 or 2 days of shoot, I'm up for it.
So what about casting? Are you casting gonna cast Yash Nagarkoti in any of the projects?
I'm sorry?
Is casting
I don't gonna think cast so. Yash Nagarkoti? No. I don't think so.
Strict policy against it, yes.
Kind of.
But I think I'm done with my questions. And thank you so much, actually, for joining in.
Press the bell icon so that you don't miss any updates from Workspace.